fellow YouTubers. In this video, I'm going to show you a little more, go into a little more detail on this power monitor, which I got from a gent called Clinton, which I did a previous review on. I'm going to do a comparison with on his, go into a little more detail, and also do a comparison against the Efergy, or what would compare as an AL meter, and then also against my Fluke 43B. So I'm going to be showing you a few bits and pieces, and I just want a little disclaimer in terms of people who might be thinking of connecting up their own power meters to their DB board. As you can see, I've got my DB board open. I've got the live wires exposed, which is of course dangerous unless you know what you're doing. If you touch those, you can electrocute yourself. Here in South Africa, our voltage is anywhere between 220 and 240 volts with a fair amount of current, so you can certainly do yourself harm. So I just want to warn people, don't meddle with power meters or connect power meters to your DB board unless you know what you're doing. I just want to show you, I have got to say, this is a current clamp for the Fluke. There's another one for the Efergy, and then the one for the CH monitor, which is Clinton's power monitor, is sitting at the top there. They're all across the main live input, main live feed into my DB board. The Fluke has two probes which you connect to pick up the voltage, and the Efergy does not. You have to manually set the voltage on it, which is, I say, one of its weak points and downfalls, but we'll cover that right now. So mainly, I mean, the main reason I'm doing this review, and you'll have to excuse the lighting, it's a little challenging, I've got some bright light behind me. The amazing reason I'm doing this review is that I'm really impressed by what this gent Clinton has produced in this power monitor. Prior to buying my Fluke 43B, I searched high and low to find a reasonably priced meter I could use for consumption measurement. I decided to pay out for the Fluke because I respect the Fluke quality and what have you. But this meter, in essence, does multiple things. It's a power quality analyzer, and you can use it as a scope as well. But it's not designed for consumption, measuring consumption. That I have to download the data, connect it to a PC, download it, and then play with it in Excel to get the figures that I want. The Efergy, and we'll just cover that off quickly, is a reasonably priced device. You can buy this single phase for roughly 800 rand, so kind of equivalent, I suppose, 50, 60, no, it would cost probably, I'm not sure what it cost in dollar terms actually, but I know other people are using them. It's wireless, it's got this little transmitter, but its main fault and fallback is, for one, you can't download the data, get the raw data and play with it yourself. You've got to load it into its proprietary software, and which isn't that great. Also, it's only picking up that current feed. So when it's measuring power, it can't take into account power factor. If you've got any power factor differences, which invariably you do, it's inaccurate. And I've had to set the voltage. You can set the voltage on this, which I use as a calibration tool. But of course, that can be way off. And when you set the voltage to something that's producing roughly the correct reading, it's going to go out if you've got any power factor difference, and that's case in point when I compare it against the other 2 meters. It can be out by as much as 8 or 10%, which certainly isn't great if you're trying to do some good consumption readings. Right, let's just, before I go into showing the details on Clinton's monitor, we'll just look at, and I've been comparing its accuracy over a week or so. You'll see it does show you power factor, it shows you the amps which are being drawn and the voltage, and I've checked these and I've calibrated them. It has got a menu system where you can actually calibrate them if you want to calibrate against another reference, and for that reference I use both my Fluke 43B and a multimeter. It then displays in the display, it gives you your carbon, what you doing in terms of carbon footprint. It gives you your consumption in rand terms, which is obviously the South African monetary denomination. You can configure that, and then the number of kilowatt hours you're using. And if we have a look at the moment, and then it gives you the power, you can see 1398, which is almost very close to what the Fluke is showing. I often see only about a 1% difference, and you can see the Efergy is off by a fair bit. I mean, this is showing 1.3 now, and we're actually up to 1.5, 1.52 on the others. So the Efergy seriously does fall down in this regard, because it's not actually measuring the voltage, and it can't cater for, say, the power factor issue. So in terms of accuracy, what Clinton has put together in this power meter is very good. What it also does, it has these graphs as well. This one over here shows you what's happening each minute, and it's basically, it's got 1 second intervals, so it's very quick to show you if you power something on and what's happening. This graph over here is showing you what has happened over 2 hours, if I remember correctly, and the bottom graph here is showing you over 60 hours. So you can actually get a profile of the electricity over 60 hours. If I then push the key up, you get the bigger graphs, individual graphs. This one is showing what's happened in the last 2 minutes. You've obviously got your real-time readings at the top as well, so you can see what's going on there. This graph over here shows you what's happened, I think if I remember correctly, in the last 2 hours. And then you can get onto this display, your bar graph, where you can use a cursor and go and select over the last 24 hours what's happened. You can put the cursor on each of these bars, and then you get a reading, hour 12. It tells you how many kilowatt hours and the cost of the kilowatt hours of your consumption. So that gives you across each hour for the day. And then here you go across a month. So I can move that cursor. So it's on day 11, I used 13.92 kilowatt hours, and that's the price that it cost me. The next screen is actually blank. It used to show total harmonic distortion and also the waves. But he removed that to save some CPU power, and he's going to add a graph there for me. I've asked him to add a graph which shows across each month, so you can see get a profile over a year, in essence, of what you're using. This goes back to the main screen. You can also, what you can do is, on this front screen, you can use the cursors to show. This is showing you what you've paid over the last month for your electricity. If I flick the switch, it'll show you the last 48 hours, last 24 hours, and the last hour, which I think is brilliant. It just gives you a lot of functionality on the screen. The other thing it does do, if you've noticed, there's a red glow. It's actually got a little LED. It's some may call gimmicky, but not for a consumer. You can the light changes at different power intervals. It goes from orange to green depending on how much power you're drawing, just to give some rough indication. So the really handy points for someone in terms of if they're doing energy audits or power consumption monitoring is, for one, it logs to an SD card, which is in the side here, and it logs to a simple text CSV log file, giving you your true power, your frequency, voltage, the amps, and you can download that and put it into an Excel spreadsheet very easily and graph out what you want. Or in fact, Clinton has his own web. You can upload it to a web page, and it graphs it for you. And that is very powerful, because when you on site doing energy audits, let's say what I do with my Fluke, I've got several issues with the Fluke. For one, I cannot flick between screens when I'm logging and see what's going on. I have to leave it on a logging screen. If I want to then download the data, I have to stop the logging, disconnect everything, put in a an optical USB cable, and then download the information to obviously a proprietary Fluke program to export it to CSV or what have you. One of the other issues I have is that the Fluke, you obviously need to plug into a separate power supply. There it is down there. So you have to find a plug nearby. You have to run an extension cable. So it becomes quite cumbersome installing this and leaving an expensive unit like this at a client. Whereas this power monitor, very simple, although it's got this AC power point in the side, which can obviously be unplugged, although I have it plugged into a plug at the moment, it could quite easily, because this powers the device as well as picks up the voltage, I could add crocodile clips onto this, so no need to find a power outlet. I can just clip that onto the board. So I've got one single clip into the board, which gives me the power supply for the unit and then also picks up the voltage. And then obviously it's got its current tap, and then when I want to download the information, I just simply pull the SD card up, put it into your computer, or switch it if I've got long-term logging happening on site, switch it for another one, and it automatically starts writing a new log file to that when you pull it out. So it really, really is good. As you can see at the moment, the light has actually gone green. I assume one of our either the pool pump or something is switched off. So it's actually gone to a green mode at the moment. If I switch on the kettle, we'll see how quickly it does react. So there we go, I've just switched on the kettle, and you can see straight away picks up the obviously the draw and the current. I'll just switch it off. Before I do switch it off, let's just have a look. 2,940 odd. It's still within 1% of the Fluke basically. And in this case, because it's a resistive load, the power factor is near 1. The Efergy is not doing too bad in this case in terms of understanding. But when the load goes off, things change a bit. So if I switch the power off, we're at 736. We're at about 740 there, so we're not far off there. Okay, the power is dropping, but the Efergy is showing a fair bit different. We're now up to 700 on close to 790 odd. There's obviously a few bits changing in the house, but certainly the Efergy, as I've tracked it over time, sometimes it's on, obviously when the power factor isn't too different, but other times it's out by a fair amount. Anyway, I thought that was just an interesting rundown for a meter which basically costs a 20th of my Fluke. And I've seen, again, I've seen other manufacturers who have tried to produce something similar, but they still cost the equivalent of roughly $2,000. Whereas this is probably like the equivalent of roughly $200. So I must say, hats off to the gent. His website, if you are more interested to go and have a look at what he's doing, is www.chtech.co.za. And if you do have any questions or queries about this or these monitors, then certainly do drop me a line, and subscribe if you do enjoy this series. Thanks very much for watching.